Penguin Random House Audio presents Sisterhood Heals, The Transformative Power of Healing in Community. This is the author, Dr. Joy Harden Bradford. A quick note to all my listeners out there. Shout out to y'all for joining me. Throughout this time, I will be offering thoughts and questions for reflection, and I'd like to suggest that you carry your journal or a small notebook with you on this journey so that you might have space to return to them throughout our time together. To my sisters, may we always see one another. I sent my baby to the window to buy ice cream on her own while I kept watch from the car directly across from where she was standing. Some guys came up next to her, greeted her politely, and stood patiently. One began engaging her in light conversation. I saw in her body language that she was getting nervous and was on my way to stand with her when this super fly sister with a fade, sundress, and dragon wing tattooed back piece came out of nowhere and said, "Hey, little sis, it's a good day for ice cream, huh?" Then placed herself between my daughter and the guy. All of Zoe's tension melted away. Super Sister stayed with her until she got her cone and walked her back to my car, where she winked at me before saying, "She did fine, Mama. We're all watching." She motioned over to her own car, and there were four sisters outside of it, all grinning and giving me the thumbs up. I think that says a lot about how angels work, how the village works, how Black women work. We out here, holy and fabulous, and ready to ride out at any time, even at the ice cream shop. Whitney Syfax Walker, Facebook post. Introduction. If there is one thing I can always count on, it is the fact that if I put five or more Black women in a room, any group of Black women, things are about to get real. With very little provocation or directing, we're likely going to get to the heart of things and fast. We won't shy away from talking about relationships, parenting, racism, work, or any other topic. Deep belly laughs will be heard and knowing glances exchanged. Perhaps some tears will be shed and secrets confided or imparted as well. In the sisterhood that Black women share, there is often a safety and an inherent feeling of support and acceptance that is affirming and, I believe, life-saving. Don't get me wrong. I know we don't live in a utopia, nor are Black women monolithic. Not all Black women want to come together and sing kumbaya with one another. But without a doubt, there is a cadence and rhythm to our gatherings. More often than not, when we convene, there is a natural sisterhood that breeds openness, protectiveness, and a tenderness with one another. A powerful something that is hard to find in other places. Just go to Essence Fest or a Beyoncé concert, any grand gathering of Black women, and you're sure to feel it. It's an energy that cannot be duplicated. I'm also clear that this magical thing that Black women experience with one another is something uniquely our own. Maybe some of it has to do with our shared understanding of the challenges and traumas that exist at the intersection of race and gender. Maybe it's something that we've cultivated to create community for ourselves in the face of attempts to strip away our humanity. As interdisciplinary scholar Evelyn Hammond says in Patricia Hill Collins' groundbreaking book, Black Feminist Thought, "I think most of the time you have to be there to experience it. When I am with other Black women, I always laugh. I think our humor comes from a shared recognition of who we all are in the world. Whatever it is, to me, a gathering of Black women is sacred. It is magical. It is healing. And it has become my life's work." I am a licensed psychologist based in Atlanta, Georgia, Since 2009, I have worked with women individually as well as in group therapy settings. In 2014, I founded Therapy for Black Girls, TBG, an organization dedicated to making mental health more relevant and accessible for Black women through our podcast, therapist directory, community platform, and blog. The idea for TBG came to me after watching the Black Girls Rock Awards on BET. I remember being totally captivated by the program that night. From thousands of miles away, the energy of the remarkable women in that room was palpable, infectious even. Sitting on a couch in my living room, I saw women standing up, literally, to celebrate one another's achievements, shining a light on important issues, and just gathering together to share their gifts as Black women. Women who excelled in areas like education, entertainment, and philanthropy were all getting and giving one another their proverbial roses. It was truly a sight to behold. It felt warm and familiar, as spaces with Black women often do. As I watched, I thought to myself, wouldn't it be cool to try and create something with this same kind of energy for Black women related to mental health? The name Therapy for Black Girls came to me quite naturally, and that night I jumped on GoDaddy to purchase the domain. When I started TBG, it was a blog where I would share posts to help make mental health topics more relevant and accessible for Black women. Because I felt that there were not enough mental health resources in the wellness industry that spoke to Black women specifically, a few of the first posts I shared were basic questions to ask a potential therapist and how to rely on your support system. I knew that there would be an audience, but to be completely honest, I was not prepared for the outpouring of sisters who were drawn to the blog and to the larger TBG community. Today, TBG has grown to include a weekly podcast that has amassed more than 34 million downloads, a directory of more than 6,000 therapists across the United States and in Canada who love doing meaningful clinical work with Black women and girls, and perhaps most important, a vibrant and engaged community of more than 700,000 sisters around the world who have a similar goal: to work toward prioritizing their mental health and becoming the best possible versions of themselves. Of course, I didn't know it at the time, but the training and experience I've had in areas like consultation, outreach, and group therapy prepared me well for the work I've done to serve this rapt audience of Black women. I was first introduced to the practice of facilitating therapy groups as an intern in the Counseling Center at Virginia Commonwealth University, VCU, in 2005. As I learned the art and nuance of leading group sessions, collectively talking through issues ranging from relationship problems to career quandaries, I fell in love with the modality and the power and possibilities of group work. In fact, I was so drawn to this form of therapy as a pathway to healing that I can draw a direct line from the work I do now to those early experiences. When I think about the current work of TBG, I conceptually view it as one long-standing, gigantic group. The community is made up of many different types of sisters, but at the heart of it, just like the people drawn to group therapy sessions, we all want to be well. And as a psychologist, I am keenly aware that for Black women, wellness and healing often happens with and because of one another. My approach to group therapy is also what contributes to how I facilitate the sister circle community I formed as a part of TBG. Every week, sisters from around the world gather on Zoom for what I call 3 for Thursday to share their hearts and listen as we explore the topic of the week. It's also how I believe the dynamics of our personal sister friendships play out. We heal in community. We always have. Every Thursday afternoon when I log off that Zoom at 1 o'clock, I am reminded of the importance of this work. This book will ultimately explore the healing power of sisterhood and what it looks like throughout our lives and during our interactions with other sisters. I want to help you to strengthen, heal, and celebrate not just your individual friendships and your sister circle, but also who we are as a collective of Black girls. As writer and playwright Intozake Shange once said, "When I die, I will not be guilty of having left a generation of girls behind, thinking that anyone can tend to their emotional health other than themselves." I'm very proud of how the collective we've built acts as a harbor and a lighthouse for each of us and the sisters who follow. Every Thursday, Andrea from Massachusetts, Mary from Seattle, Paula and Dee Dee from New York, Mona and Nia from Atlanta, and Tanya and Carla from D.C. come together with Jasmine in North Carolina, Melissa in Chicago, Anya in...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.